boys and girls. Okay, I need you to settle down now. Guess what? I have a story for you. It's about a little girl. You ready? Once upon a time, in a distant land, far beyond the sea, where there lived no man or woman. In fact, lo and behold, the oldest person there was only 12 years old, 'cause all the grown-ups had washed away in a flood. One town in particular there was called Mud, because every sister, cousin, and brother, from head to toe in mud, they were covered. But anyway, in this town called Mud, there lived a little girl named Penelope Judd. Now Penelope was a very sad, sad girl, because she was living in a bad, bad world, where kids teased each other and acted really mean. They lied, cheated, and stole, and their speech was obscene. With no grown-ups around, nobody was really wise, so every kid did what was right in their own eyes. Penelope would cry, like every single day. No matter what she did, the tears wouldn't go away. But deep down in her heart, she hoped it would get better, because of what her grandpa had written in the letter. He said,
"Penelope, it's great news that I bring. On the mountaintop, there lives a great king. The king has a son, and being a proud father, he's gonna throw the prince a huge party in his honor. But the good part, and I hope it gets you excited, Penelope Judd, you're officially invited. He's sending a dog, he'll tell you all you need to know. Just have your bags packed and be ready to go."
It had been such a long time Penelope was waiting. She wondered if the letter was true or just faking. But one day she was playing outside, and to a great surprise, the dove had arrived. He said,
"We go with no delay. Don't let nobody try to make you stay. We're gonna see the king, we're on our way. And all the old things gonna pass away.
Your turn,
off
your turn.
We go with no delay. Don't let nobody try to make me stay. We're gonna see the king, we're on our way. And all the old things gonna pass away."
The dove told her that he was sent by the king. If she wanted to go, she had to run and grab her things. Penelope said, "Okay, I'll be right back." Ran into the house and came back out with her knapsack. The dove said,
"Penelope, the party is in a day. Stay alert, follow me, and I'll lead the way."
So as he flew and Penelope walked the path, she waved goodbye to her friends and they started to laugh. They said that she was silly for following the dove, just to go to some stupid party up above. Penelope and the dove continued on their way, but then she got sad 'cause part of her wanted to stay. But then she thought to herself, "Why would I want to stay? 'Cause all they do is play in the mud all day. And while they're doing that, I'm going to see the king." It made Penelope so happy she started to sing. She said,
"I go with no delay, and ain't nobody gonna make me stay. I'm gonna see the king, I'm on my way, and all the old things gonna pass away."
Your turn, your turn.
I go with no delay, and ain't nobody gonna make me stay. I'm gonna see the king, I'm on my way, and all the old things gonna pass away.
Now when they had been walking for a long time, they reached the foot of the mountain and they started to climb. Penelope got scared, not sure if she could keep going because the mountain was very, very steep. On top of that, it was now dark outside. The dove said,
"Keep your eyes on me, I'll be your guide."
Getting to the top was a difficult trip, but the dove was there to pick her up whenever she slipped. And she was so excited when they got near the top that she didn't even stop when her knapsack dropped. The dove led her to the palace and said,
"Farewell, see you inside."
He flew away, Penelope rang the bell. A huge angel answered, looked her up and down. She knew something was wrong because he had a big frown.
"Can I help you, ma'am?"
"Yes, I'm here for the party. I have an invitation."
He said,
"I'm so sorry. There's no way that I can let you through these doors. The king won't let anyone dirty up his floor."
She didn't understand, so without coming near her, he reached into his pocket and he pulled out a mirror. And for the very first time, she saw that she was dirty. The palace was spotless. She knew she wasn't worthy. As the angel continued,
"I'm sorry, little friend, but
a voice inside the party said,
you can let her in."
The next thing she knew, the prince himself was at the door. He looked at her, smiled, and said,
"There's room for one more."
He reached out and touched her. Instantly, she was clean, wearing the brightest robe that she had ever seen. If the mud kids had seen it, they would have of going blind. Where'd you get it? She asked. He said,
actually, it's mine.
And as he let her in through the palace door, he sang the sweetest song she ever heard before. He said,
long ago, laid aside my crown, became a mud kid, traveled to your town. They kicked me out, didn't want me around, but those who love me get to share my crown.
Your turn,
long
your turn.
Long ago, laid aside his crown, became a mud kid, traveled to our town.